Thanks, and thank you for allowing me to come up here this morning. Unfortunately, all of my cars had wheels and tires on them, so, you know, it was the world But anyway, Dan McConnell, I'm an arts undergrad from the design school in Pasadena. I left school, did a five-year tour of duty, so to speak, over in Europe with Peugeot Citroën, and being an LA guy, you know, my idea of a small car was kind of just a little bit smaller than what George's car is over there. When I got over to Europe, I realized, oh my God, you know, the size of a fender is the size of the total length of a vehicle in Europe. So it was a great cultural learning experience, and design learning experience especially. Got a little homesick, came back and joined Mitsubishi when they first opened up in the United States back in the early 1980s. And spent most of my adult life there, leaving as chief designer a few years ago. And I think I'm back here with a slightly less gray beard. But this was the staff of guys and the team of people I worked with there, and we did a lot of great stuff, and you know, this was the team that I was basically the number two American guy there at Mitsubishi. So I think, you know, I was trying to think what was the most fun part about Mitsubishi. I think looking back, it was the fact that we did every generation of Eclipse that was ever done. From the first one back in, I think, 88, and that's, in fact, when I first met George when he first started Auto Pacific, I think, to the last one in about 2010, 2011. And what was great about this car and this vehicle as a designer was that, you know, the Eclipses were always vehicles, again, as creative people. You never looked backwards. It was always about what was coming over the horizon. What was next? What would be the car that no one else could do or had the potential of doing? And that's what I think that was the beauty of and the fun about. Every time the product cycle came around to start the new Eclipse, it was like, let's get on that. And it was just really a great way to, again, look up at the what's on the horizon for as far as sporty cars were concerned. I left Mitsubishi in about 2010, I think, and I joined Catskin Automotive in leather. And we're a small company based here in LA, and we are the industry leader in ready to install leather interiors for all makes and models of vehicles in the United States. We're sort of a small company. We are a small, big company, I guess you might say. And we're a company that not many people know about, so we're trying to spread the word about that this product category exists, not only to consumers, but to automotive companies as well. We have not only supply to dealers, but we also are the industry pioneer in special edition Buzz model interiors. And we brought one of those with us out. There's a Wrangler out in the courtyard, if you have time to later look at. But this has been a great experience for myself as a creative person to bring design into a company that really never had design before, that never really prioritized design, but to show that the power of what design can do to take a company from one place to another, and again, looking over the horizon of what can be achieved and what can be accomplished through design. And also in the sense that, you know, people don't want, I think we've touched on this a little this morning, you know, people don't just want the regular thing, they want something different, they want something that is beyond the ordinary. And I think that this is a product category that lets people achieve that in a way that maybe a lot of folks don't know even exists. So in addition to that, I've been doing some consulting. I wouldn't even call it consulting. I'd say it's like I'm a creative advisor to a few companies around town here. And I work sometimes with some local OEMs. I was working for a while with Bertone in Italy, which was really exciting. My Italian was terrible, but it was some really great exciting projects to work with. Did some work with General Electric Medical in the past. Do a lot of work with some SEMA-based related companies. And a fun project I just did was I got a call from the folks at Automobile Magazine, and they said, hey, what would you think a 2016 Camaro would look like? And I thought, wow, what a great project. And I thought, oh my God, what a dangerous thing to do at the same time. Because it's kind of like, wow, it's a really emotional thing. And I'm an old Camaro, you know, Mustang kind of guy. But they gave me a little intel from the planning side, and I was able to do this. It came out, and they did. This was in their futures issue that was a couple, I think it was last month, and so I was very comforted to see that they printed it, first of all, and then some other design friends of mine did the Audi A8 and the Miata X3 on the following pages. So this is kind of as an independent guy, sometimes you cast a wide net, you end up doing a lot of very interesting things on the side. Then also, a third part of my life is spent with Rob and a lot of the other great people here in this room up at Art Center. I'm on the faculty there. I've been teaching there probably about 12 or 13 years now, I guess, already. And my responsibility is I am a junior level instructor, junior student level instructor, We handle the corporate sponsored projects, so it's really a lot of fun working with young designers, you know, guys and gals in their early 20s, teaching them design skills, modeling skills. But we also work with the various corporations around town, the OEs. So, for example, this photo on the bottom, your lower right there, is a project we just finished up with Toyota. And it wasn't just Toyota, Toyota Motor Sales and Carson. It was working with the guys at Calte down in Newport Beach. So it was this great collaboration of what's coming next in terms of product design, product category. And the guys at Toyota are just as eager to find out from the students what's new as the students are to deliver on some of these ideas. Where this really falls into place with what we're talking about today is the fact that I think that my experience with the students is that when you mention the future of driving and the experience of driving, 50% of it is the topic of autonomous control comes up. So I think that's really noteworthy about where the young design generation, where their heads are at right now in terms of, you know, how should I say, you know, where are we going with the automotive industry? So that's a quick flyover. And again, thank you for your time this morning, and I look forward to joining the panel later on.